Howdy, folks. Welcome to our new series. It's going to be called Little Known Facts About America, featuring the Randy Rogers Band. Today, we're going to be exploring some interesting historical places of interest in our nation's capital, Washington, D.C. So come along with us and let the learning begin. Here. We're in front of the nation's capital. I was just going to take a second to tell you a little bit about the history of America. America was originally named just America. Just America, starting with an M. And people that still know better, people that really know their history, will still refer to it as just America. The A was later added.
Go.
Here we are out in front of the capital, our nation's capital.
And, oh.
Yeah, right over there. And, I found the statue of the famous horse from the movie Flicka. Not real sure who the guy riding is, but it's rumored to be Chuck Norris. I don't know, we're going to look into that.
What do we want? You hear crab cakes? What do you want?
Who are we? What do we want?
Crab cakes.
When do we want it?
Now.
Who are we? What do we want?
Squirrel trees.
Very quiet. Right now we found one of the rarest species. They're very hard to find here in Washington, D.C. It's called the Protester. We're going to see if we can sneak over there and capture one. Crikey! I think there's too many of them. We're not going to be able to capture one today. We've got a serious hardcore fence right here around them. Keep them all in line. Maybe we'll come back later and see if we can capture one.
Go. Large pillars, steps, large doors. What do these things all have in common? All things that remind me of art. What we're fixing to go see. We're gonna go see some art. It's at the top of the stairs, past the pillars, through the large doors. Before being used to keep your dog from biting on his own nuts, this was an early fashion statement from the 17th century.
Hey, do this so you can't see your feet unless like we're walking.
Here we are inside the Matrix.
Wait, I gotta get my America hat on.
Oh wait, hold on.
America.
Go.
All right, well, here we are at the National Air and Space Museum. Behind me, you can see the lunar module that was actually used to film the moon landing, a pretty famous movie that came out in the 60s. The special effects weren't very good back then, so I'm sure if they had filmed it now, it would have looked a lot more realistic. been to the Battleship Texas, you've probably seen the San Jacinto Monument, and a little known fact, this guy right here is an exact replica of the San Jacinto Monument. It's called the Washington Monument, and it's carved in his image and likeness.
Who's it named after?
George Washington Carver, I think, right?
He was famous for...
He invented the peanut.
Nice.
Here at the Washington Monument, which, a little known fact also, is one of the world's largest sundials. You can kind of tell from the sun right now. We're standing at about, what time is it, Chelsea?
It's
1258.
Go. Back in '06, there's a flood, you see. There's a water line on them rocks. You can tell where the water line used to be. It's from the flood line.
Seeing as the Washington Monument is one of our nation's most treasured monuments, it's very carefully guarded by a couple of guards over there. They're here just to make sure that no one steals it. I think it'll be okay.
Alright, so everybody knows the story of Thomas Jefferson and his wooden teeth, his famous wooden teeth. Little known fact, his wooden teeth went on to inspire Abraham Lincoln to make a set of wooden teeth of his own. He improved on them and made them petrified wooden teeth, which he used to bite through the bones of his enemies. And that's a large part of why they won the Revolutionary War. And as you can see behind us, this is some petrified wood, much like the wood that Abraham Lincoln used to make his teeth. Best known for moving on up to the east side, Thomas Jefferson was born in the early 1600s, I believe. And you might also recognize his face from the $1 bill. Like many presidents before him, like Ronald Reagan, he was into movies and stuff, and now he's a statue.
He was also famous for his nickname TJ, just like Tommy Jackson.
Absolutely.
You may have wondered where Payne Stewart got the inspiration for his famous Knickers outfit. And it's a little known fact that Thomas Jefferson was actually the inventor of the Knickers, as you can see here in his statue. He's sporting them with the traditional boots of the style, which have nowadays been replaced with golf shoes.
Oh, crikey.
The Lincoln Town Car. The Lincoln Continental. The Lincoln Tunnel. Lincoln Park. The Lincoln Memorial. All great things, all inspired by one great man with a funny hat. Abraham Lincoln, the fifth president of the United States, was a great man, known for many great things, including his cameo in the movie Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. And if we could just remember some of his famous words, be excellent to one another and party on, dudes. We're out.
Started it, you and it. Go.
All right, guys. Thanks for coming along on our little journey. I hope it was really informative. Make sure you tune in next time for Little Known Facts About America with the Randy Rogers Band.
The Lincoln Tunnel, Lincoln Park, Lincoln Logs, all great things, all inspired by one great man. The Lincoln Tunnel, Lincoln Logs, Lincoln Park, the Lincoln Memorial, all great things, all inspired by one man in a funny hat. Abraham Lincoln was the sixth president of the United States, and he led our wonderful country to glory on numerous occasions. I don't know anything about this guy. I can't do it, man.